I want to welcome Chief Bellegarde here and Chief Archibald. Great to see both of you. I look forward to sitting down and having a great discussion. And I'm just so happy that they came today.
I wouldn't get hung up on whether or not the word genocide is used. I'd be more focused on the implementation plan on the recommendations. That's the big thing, because we really want to stop and end violence against women and girls. That's really what it's about. And I think we can get our heads around that. You'll see progress. When you look at the definition of genocide in the UN conventions, there's five elements, and you just have to meet one of them. Like even forcibly removing children from homes, that happened. Inflicting pain, like forced sterilization, that happened. So it meets, so it's starting. I would just encourage all Canadians and all leaders, yes, to look at the definition of genocide, but again, to focus on the next steps for implementation of the National Action Strategy for dealing with different programs, strategies, piece of legislation to end violence against women and girls. I would think that with the upcoming election in October, I think all federal parties have an obligation to make this one of their key party platform planks. And it's up to us as well as First Nations people to make sure there's other priorities in there, like ending boil water advisories, making sure the quality of life, we have good access to good health care, good educational outcomes, start looking at justice reforms. Those are going to be all part of that package, and it should be there. Well, with the Council of the Federation, all the premiers come together, and one of the issues we want to make sure that we deal with, which a few years back there was a consensus to deal with, was dealing with child welfare. We have 40,000 children in foster care in provincial systems, territorial systems, and we know that's not acceptable. There's more children in care now than at the height of the residential school system. So I think if we want to build a better province and build a better country, we should start making the investments in those the fastest growing segment of Canada's population, young First Nations men and women. And that's one of the things we're going to be focusing on.